Okay, hey guys. Wow. What a session. That was cool. Don't remember anything yet, so I'm gonna have to go back and watch. For everybody that is wondering what I'm using during my sessions. Okay, my quartz or my rose quartz. What I do with this is I let it open up my heart center to receive clear and positive communications. I also use I don't even know what the hell this thing is. Just a smoky quartz. So it kind of just transmits the energy and focuses myself, lets me focus more. Just I find it, they balance me out. So those are two stones that I really use a lot. And the board I use during my sessions, this is actually the one from 1950s into the 60s. So it's in between 1955 and 60. It is wooden. Actually, I think it's masonite. I'm not sure. But it does have the rounded edges. It's in very good condition. Except for you can see some wear and tear up on where the Ouija is. So, I mean, that's the board I use. This is my baby. But yeah, and then just the regular planchette. Doesn't have a little thingy. Oh, that Buffy quote. That was funny. I thought it was anyway. But yeah, that's the board I use. The wooden board, the big, big one, 1938. The other one, 1972. 72 or 3. The other one, 1972. Two or three, 1999, yeah, and that's like four or five boards, six. I don't know, I feel this one not vibes with me, so it's my board, my baby, and I just love it. And it was my very first gift, Ouija gift, from my very good friend Pam, whom I love to death, and I miss you. Your food. I miss your pie. I could cry. But yeah, that's how I do it. And everybody that's asking me, you know, for one, I'm very glad that you're all going out and getting these books by Karen. Amazing. Spirit of Alchemy, Spirits of Ouija. The Heart and Hip Meditation, I don't. What I do is I like to position myself, make sure your hips are firmly planted. I take my right hand, put it down with my rose quartz, left hand up. I see it as a cycle, a circle of energy. So I just kind of do the breathing as exactly as Karen says. I do notice a lot of thoughts and stuff that pop up. So, that's normal. But, yes. Good books. Go get them. I shit you not, they are about the best books you can get. So, yeah. That's just a little bit of my prepping for the Ouija, and then the after session, I just, like I do on, you know, on here, I thank my guides, my grandma, and they usually say goodbye. Or I have to say goodbye and I itch because I'm sunburnt, peeling. It's disgusting. Yeah, if you guys want, you know, question and answers, that was my first healing through the board. I don't know if it worked or not. Yeah, just kind of, you know, comment, subscribe, like, send me an email, Ryan, R-Y-A-N-J, Espich, E-S-P-I-C-H, @gmail.com. And I will, yeah, more than happy to help, give advice. So yeah, that's just my tip on how I start my session. And if it wasn't for Karen, yeah, I'd be on a downhill spiral, but that's not always a bad thing. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Sorry, I know, I'm working on the smoking. But yeah, massive love to all of you. You're all amazing. And yeah, send me an email. Let me know what you think. Subscribe, like. And yeah, talk to me. I love to talk and be social. But alright, thanks guys. Okay, question and answer with Veronica, episode I don't know. And I only have really one question today, but one question can take an hour. Okay, and we've been talking. Alright, so Ganny. Okay, yesterday after talking to Janice, somebody pointed out that a lot of spirits can't find their spouses or children on the other side. Why is that? It seems that they're always looking and they can't find them. So, why can't they find their spouses or children? Janice was looking for someone and she couldn't find him. Different. D. I. M. E. N. S. I. They're in different dimensions. Yes. Okay. Do they ever find each other again? Oh, no. W.
B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-A-R-E-B-O-S-
you in DT. When some spirits are bound to earth, T H E, wow, that feels really weird. Y R C O N F U S E D. They're confused. A N D T O N T K N O W. Whoa. T H E Y. Don't know. They C A N P A S S I N T O T H E I R N E X T R E A L M. So they don't, when they become earthbound, they don't know that they can pass on to their next dimension. Yes. Okay, so say for instance, I get a spirit that is looking for someone. What would I do? What would you do? A S S I S T assist I N R E S O L V I N G. Resolving T H E I R resolving there. I. S. S. U. E. S. So if I ever come across them, just talk to them and assist them and help them to assist them with their problem and try to get them to pass over or pass on. A. N. D. R. E. M. I. N. D. T. H. E. M. T. H. E. I. R. D. A. D. And remind them that they're dead. Yes. So that's really there all there is to it. F. O. R. A. M. E. D. I. U. M. L. I. K. E. Y. O. U. R. S. E. L. F. Yes. For a medium like myself, yes. Okay. R. E. M. I. N. D. T. H. E. M. Remind them. H. O. W. L. O. V-E-T-T-H-E-Y-A-R-E. Remind them how loved they are. Yes. Okay, that makes really good sense. I mean, that helps me a lot. Was Janice actually trying to find somebody? H E R B A L L A N D C H A I and her ball and chain. Is she earthbound? S H E she I S I M A R E A L M. She's in a realm. T H A T. D G O. She's on her own, that people that OD go? Yes. Does she know that she is passed on? I T H I N K, I think B U T S H E, but she W A N T S T O C O N T I N U E L I K E-S-H-E-D-I-D, like she did. She wants to continue like she did in life. Okay. So who was her ball and chain that she was looking for? M? Her manager? Is he even alive? No. S H E I S E V O L V I N She is evolving, though. So that means that she will find... She'll be at peace. Once and for all. Okay, good. Okay, and then, okay, Mercury retrograde is coming, and it's tomorrow. What simple... I need some kind of simple charm or something to help. Because I get really bitchy. C. A. O. L. L. M. E. R C U R Y call Mercury S I G I L sigil M A G I C sigil magic A L C H E M Y Alchemy, sigil magic. Yes. T that I S Y O U R E E S T B E T. That's my best bet, is sigil magic. Yes. Oh, thank you. I knew something. Okay, and then I have a question. So moving for, oh, yes. Yes. Okay, I have a friend. His name is Christopher Stephen Paul Walker. He lives in the UK. And I was kind of hoping maybe with the pyramid crystal right there, we could transmit some energy, transfer energy to him to kind of help heal him. M O P R O B L E M. No problem. S T A N D B Y. Stand by. S E N D I N G H I M H E A N G. Sending him healing. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I don't know if this is the process. H E L I K What? E S U. Stop, Ganny. No, don't say that stuff over here. And don't you smile at me like that. That's not... We're sending him healing. Yes. Oh. R. R. Y. Sorry, it's okay. H A V E T O G I V E U H A R D T I M Yeah, I know you're giving me a hard time. I love you. Oh. Okay, is that part of the process too? Sun and the moon? Okay. Alright, Yanny, that was a good session. Thank you for answering those questions and helping. And the healing, and I appreciate it so much. So much. But I'm gonna say goodbye, and I love you, and I will talk to you privately later. Okay, Gani, I love you more, and I will talk to you later. Alright. Whoa. Ugh, that hurts.